Right, so chaps, I've gathered us all together, the Wheeler Dealer family, to discuss the big news. Because at the moment, my house is full of packing cases, suitcases.
Oh!
I've got my passport in my hand as I head back to the UK, and bringing with me in the suitcase is the show Wheeler Dealers.
Can you bring the weather as well?
I can bring the weather. That'd be nice because that's the one thing I'm going to miss. I'm so going to miss that about California, the one thing I'm really going to miss. We've had an amazing 6 years here, but we have been inundated with the audience saying, why don't you come home? When are you coming home? And we do listen to the audience, and we do feel that after our 6 years of being here, it's now time to return back to our roots. There's a whole host of reasons to do that. But I'm really excited about it, but sad at the same time. The reason I'm excited is we're coming back to England, and we're going to be making Wheeler Dealers back in the rain and the snow through the winter. But the bad news is, unfortunately, Ant is only going to be popping in to see us every now and then. And the good news is Elvis is taking over in the workshop. So how do you feel about it?
Elvis, you better go, buddy. Say really nice things.
Well, go on, Ant. I mean, I want to know how you feel about this, because this has been your baby now for a few years, and I'm coming at this fresh, coming it from the outside. But this must be a hard thing for you to kind of let go.
Well, do you know what? It's interesting because, you know, it was a massive life change for me. Obviously, moving countries is very difficult in itself, but moving countries and taking over an established show was kind of overwhelming. But now that, you know, some years have passed, I've really settled in, but I really have established my life here. My world is here. But I'm actually incredibly excited for you, because you are where I was 4 years ago. So, you know, I know what is coming for you, the good stuff and the bad stuff. And the fact that you're in the UK means that you're actually going to deal with genuine rust.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. I've been rust lucky here in California. how are you? How do you feel about it?
Well, I'm massively excited. But, you know, I know this is a big deal, as you know, and as I'm sure you felt back in the day when you took this over. This is a huge deal. I don't think people... You know, I certainly didn't appreciate how big Wheeler Dealers is globally until you really get into it. And, you know, to be welcomed into this family, which I am, and I feel very grateful to have that happen. Massively exciting, but I'm also a bit nervous. You know, you're taking on something that's existed for a long, long time in your hands most recently. And of course, Ed, very successfully before that too. People love
it. Don't mess it up, buddy.
Thanks for the advice.
No, I'm serious. Me and Elvis have worked together closely before. It's funny because, you know, whoever I've worked with, whether it was Ed or with you, Ant, and Elvis on Dreamcar, I've always looked at what our skill sets are, and it informs the buying decision of the cars. You know, I know that you're an amazing fabricator, Ant, so when I go and see cars that need fabrication, I feel pretty sure that we're just going to knock it out of the park because you're just amazing at fabrication. Elvis took Lewis Hamilton to a Formula One world title, so I'm pretty sure he's quite good with the old engineering. So I know that skill set, and I tuned into it when we was making Dream Car, and we had a fantastic time working together. We so enjoyed each other's company.
Mike, I need to ask you a question, because, you know, you and I have been in each other's pockets. We've lived in each other's lives pretty much 24/7 for the last almost 4 years. How does this feel for you right now?
Well, for me, it's really exciting because Wheeler Dealers has got a massive future. And not only Wheeler Dealers, Wheeler Dealers Dream Car as well, because me and Elvis are going to be working that as well. So we're very excited about that. For me, I'm sad. You know, me and you have got an amazing bromance. There's no, people are going to say, oh, Brewer can't hold on to these mechanics and all that nonsense. But
People say that about me and my wives.
You know, it really is tough to say goodbye to you. And I know it's not forever. I know that we are planning to bring you in to Wheeler Dealers to pop into the shop and to help out every now and then when Elvis has got something heavy to put up.
So I'm actually going to be traveling back to the UK quite a bit next year. So I'll be able to dip in and help you. But the reason I'm traveling back is that I've got a couple of new secret projects coming up. I've got a couple of car shows that have been commissioned. I've already started on them. And I'm really, I can't tell you what they are yet because you know how TV works. This is really exciting news. And I really feel like my life is here. I've created a life here for myself. I've got a family. I've had a baby, as you know. And I hand the Wheeler Dealer baton over to you in the knowledge that I'm doing some really exciting new car shows. So between the three of us, we're going to give more car shows, more car content, more craziness, more engineering, more fixes. And, you know, I'm really proud of, I'm proud of all of us. Even you, Mike. I'm so proud of you, Mike.
Thanks very much, Ant.
What genuine advice, Ant, would you give Elvis about what's he going to face?
You know, I'm excited because you're going to be working on cars that you would never have an opportunity to work on. I know that at some stage, Mike's going to push in a brown Austin Allegro and you're going to go, it's a brown Austin Allegro. This is epic. So celebrate that, man. You only live once. Just the bad cars, the good cars, and just tell the truth. You know, we've just done a TR7 and I'm very, very vocal, possibly one of the worst cars ever made. Apologies, TR7 owners, but it is. And on top of that, it was orange. So you're going to have these moments where Mike will wheel in an orange TR7 and you're going to go, oh, actually, it's a massive privilege. So, you know, soak it up, drink it in, enjoy every moment. Now, the next thing is Mike, individually. Okay, where can I begin? Mike, do you want to switch off just for a second?
I can do.
I'm gonna tell you now that the Mike Brewer is the backbone of that show. And when I first started, I got thrown into the deep end. You know, new country, new house, new schools, new job, new workshop, and it would have been an incredibly difficult place for me to live if Mike wasn't there because he's done the show for so long. He understands it in and out. If you was to cut him in half, he would bleed Wheeler Dealers. So really lean into him. Make sure. And if you're uncomfortable with anything, you know, you don't like the car, the job, or you know, let's say he wants to change the color of a car and you don't believe that's the right decision, just pull him aside and tell him, because the one thing Mike will do is he will listen. He might not agree, but he will listen.
Yeah.
Ultimately, he wants the very, very best for the show.
Well, I think I was quite lucky in that I've had a taste of that already, of course, with the first series of Dream Car. So at least from that perspective, I'm not coming in stone cold on this. And, you know, working on that show. Yeah, working on that show was an amazing experience. And a big part of that experience was working with Mike.
What you'll find, Elvis, is that the longer you work on the show, you'll have these moments that stand out above. And so, at this stage, with the show going back to the UK, it's an opportunity for me to kind of look back fondly, remembering my favourite moments. And, your first car is going to be an important car. So, firstly, the pressure is on Mike to bring you something epic car one. Because car one for you will set the tempo for the rest of your Wheeler Dealer journey.
It's true, yeah.
It is true. And that's what Mike did for me. My first ever car. Could you imagine being a British guy born in the late 70s, turning up into California to take over this overwhelming show and all that pressure? And then you walk in the workshop and there's an Escort RS Cosworth scene.
Yeah, amazing. Yeah.
Mike kind of made it easy for me.
That's still one of my favourite shows, actually. That was amazing. Brilliant stuff.
Well, as an F1 guy, you must love the whole idea of adding aero.
Of course, yeah.
And adding Frank. And, you know, I look back at that. I am so incredibly proud of, first of all, that car, but that episode, because that episode set the tempo for me for every single Wheeler Dealer car I did since. And when a car makes an impact or a show makes an impact because people still talk about it, I still get people message me about the third wing on the Cosworth. And yes, some is negative because people don't like it, and that's fine, that's their prerogative, but some is positive.
Yeah.
And, you know, Mike and I really set out to tell stories, to inform, to talk about engineering and science. And that show was the whole package. It had the social history, it had the iconic British car, it had something that had never been done before, it had brave decisions, it had the original, you know, designer in it. And we did something that still gets talked about today. And I think that speaks volumes. So pressure is on you, Mike, to start Elvis off on the right tempo. And then Elvis,
somebody on you. Go up and see that brown Allegro for me, please.
That'll be fine. That'll be fine. Do a brown. But no, in all seriousness, I still look back, and that's almost 4 years ago for me now. I still look back at that show, that car, that day. I remember it like it was last week. And it really, yeah.
Good one.
Yeah, well, you smashed it.
I'm getting emotional now.
It's a marvelous. We've had some other breakout moments. Let's not forget the Austin.
Oh, I know. The Barracuda was epic.
3,000, the Barracuda.
Oh, the Healey. I mean, we auctioned the car for the first time ever in Wheeler Dealer history, and it's the most profitable any Wheeler Dealer car has ever made. so no pressure.
all right.
Are you how's the workshop looking? Have you got space yet?
Do you know what? Yes. We have got an amazing place. I haven't seen it yet. I'm going to see it very, very soon. I cannot wait, because that's, you know what that's like. And that's like having a Christmas present sat there that you just can't open. And I'm on my way to go and see it really soon. I can't wait.
I've been looking at places to put Wheeler Dealers because I wanted a really good destination point for people as well as the show. So we've been looking in the middle of England, Bicester, where the Bicester Heritage Centre is. They call that area a sort of gasoline alley. It's a very American way of saying things. I've looked at a workshop there. We've got a huge, great big space that we'll be taking on. And I'm looking forward to coming home in just a couple of days' time to spend some time with Elvis, walking through the workshop, deciding where we're going to put our
ball. So chair, exciting!
Where we're going to so put our exciting. Rabbit. So the good news is, as well, for everyone out there, is although this announcement is being made and I'm coming back home, Ant's staying behind in America, and I'm coming to join you, Elvis, in the workshop, me and Ant, we have another series yet to go. So we've been working flat out on a current series, which will be played out after this announcement. So we've listened to the fans. We're bringing the show all the way back to the UK. I'm very excited about it. Me and Elvis are going to be working flat out to entertain and inform you, and our new shows will be ready to view sometime late summer, early autumn. And in the meantime, you can follow us all on social media and you can see what we get up to. It's going to be amazing. I'm so proud of you guys, working with you guys. It's just been a privilege and an honor to work with you, and I love you dearly. Elvis, me and you are going to have an amazing future together. I know we are. Ant, I need you to come round here and help me pack up the last few things. Also, if you don't mind, Ant, I'm going to cry. I also need a run to the airport. I need a ride to the airport.
Okay, so, how's an orange TR7?
Your last duty as my man is my man. Would you please? I want to sit in the back of the car and you drive me to the airport.
How about I take you to the airport in an orange TR7, because you're guaranteed to probably not get there.
Hold on, I'm finished. And Elvis, I'll send you my flight details.
I'll pick you up at the other end, yeah.
Brilliant. Guys, thank you so much for this. It's been an honour and a privilege to work with both of you. And Wheeler Dealers for the future. Thank you.
Can't wait.